are you doing there? You tying your shoe?
I'm tying my shoe. You got a problem with that?
Yeah. You tie it like a little bit. Hey, welcome back to our Stupid Rex Idiots. Happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali to you and yours. Happy Diwali from the ceiling to the floors.
And I'm Corbin. This is Rick.
Yeah.
You can follow us on Instagram and Twitter.
It's so juicy.
Follow us on Patreon. Follow us on Twitter account. Ring the bell. Follow us on the YouTube channel. Links in the description below. Today, what?
They should see all of the lovely little... What do they look like to you?
Balloons.
Nah, that's not what they look like to me. Anyway, what are we doing today?
Doing a movie review.
Oh, no.
Yeah. The ongoing joke that Rick didn't watch the movie. Just wing it. Ah, we're hilarious.
We're so funny.
The new film that just came out, Ludo, which is based off of the game which you haven't played, which my wife says is similar to Parcheesi.
Ah, I put that on my spaghetti.
But this is a, say his name for me.
Oh, the director?
Director.
Anurag Basu.
He directed, wrote it, and produced it. I think we've seen one of his things before.
We have.
Barf it was.
That's it. What it was.
Okay.
It's Barf.
I was like, I know I've seen something of his.
Yep.
But it's starring a whole slew of people. Little B, or Junior B.
Right, who we have said we wanted to see in something.
Adit Roy Kapoor, who I believe we saw in... We didn't see him in the Kapoor and Sons, right? Was he in Kapoor and Sons?
I thought he...
Am I mistaken?
I thought he was.
Okay, he might have been. I don't know. You can tell me. And then Rajkumar Rao.
Yep.
And then Tripathi.
Who, I think, if we look at his resume, I think 75% of the roles he plays have his name as the character.
Is that Tripathi? Is that like an ongoing joke? Because right when he said it, I was like...
I know.
Is that in his contract?
Like every role he plays has to have that name.
Which is hilarious.
It's very strange.
But anyways, we loved the trailer. We probably thought it was the best trailer of this past year.
Yep.
We were very much looking forward to seeing it, so we watched it. We will give you just a tiny little bit of non-spoiler just because it's new.
Correct, because it's brand new.
Just because it's new. And then we'll get into it. So, Rick, your initial thoughts. Go. Non-spoiler.
Yeah, non-spoiler initial thoughts. Loved it. It's quirky. It's fun. It's an extremely difficult thing to pull off.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a breath of fresh air in the midst of sensing we have to stay like locked down through the winter.
Yeah.
To know that there's something this fun and touching and entertaining and laugh out loud funny is available to watch.
I totally agree. it lived up to what I thought the trailer was supposed to be.
I applauded when it was over. I applauded the screen.
I love the ending. non-spoilers, but non-spoilers.
Okay.
But yeah, I think it's actually a brilliant, also unique to,
especially unique.
Indian cinema.
Very
we have yet to get, at least to our knowledge, a lot of this style, which is very, I want to say, it has a couple elements of a few things. I'm not comparing him, but no. Like Quentin, what's his name? Guy Ritchie. And
the person who it reminded me of quite a bit in terms of some of the quirkiness, in terms of the use of color, was, Puss.
Who? What movie?
We love him.
You have to tell me a movie.
I know. And my brain's farting on that too. And I see his face. The comedy with Hitler. And...
Oh, Taika Waititi.
Yes.
Yeah. Very much. Yes.
Very much so like that.
He's one of my favorite directors. Watch everything he's ever done. You still haven't seen What We Do in the Shadows.
No.
That's so brilliant.
Yeah, I haven't.
Anyways. So, yeah. I think everything from the direction to the cinematography. I thought they did a great job in each character. The cinematography even went along with what piece they were supposed to be playing, basically.
So hard.
So that was great. I thought the score was really nice. Acting.
The score with the music.
The acting, especially by Tripathi and Rajkumar Rao.
And, hey, we'll talk a little bit about it, but
Abhishek Bachchan, yeah, man.
There was not one weak link in the entire thing.
Not one.
So I want to praise the director, who is also the writer and the producer.
Yep.
Anurag Basu did a phenomenal job of making a very unique, quirky film. So definitely just go watch it. It's on Netflix.
Enjoy it. You're going to enjoy. It's got a 2.5-hour runtime. It feels like a 90-minute film.
Yeah.
You'll forget all about COVID and elections and crap. And you'll just get to escape, be entertained, be made to laugh, have some touching moments, and watch some incredibly good cinematography. It's just...
And some really great quirky performances.
Great quirky performances. It's just all good.
By a lot of people. Yeah, so definitely go check it out. If you haven't seen it yet, please go watch it. We are heading into the spoiler part of the review now.
Yes.
There's lots of twists and turns in this film.
Yes.
So we don't want you to be spoiled. So go away.
Yeah. Get out of here now, because here come the spoilers.
On the bottom. Right at the end.
Yeah.
No. But yeah, like I said, I loved everything about this film. I want to praise the director even more because what he did with... just everything. He's, I guess, given the most credit for, and we've, I think, only seen one of his, and it was Barfi, which was a unique film in and of itself.
I love Barfi,
And so,
quirky. And not like this.
No.
Not nearly as difficult to pull off.
It's almost had like a Pulp Fiction-y style of, because they went and molded the stories together.
You know what it reminded me of? Not in terms of its feel or its genre, but its structure.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that we had like these different components that kept you engaged with each of the stories and they crossed each other.
Yeah.
It reminded me just in that respect to the success in Love Actually, where you're connected to each of the stories in that romantic comedy and each of the people in the story. It's a really fun, underrated...
We're not allowed to watch it here. She doesn't want to be mad at Alan Rickman.
Why would she be mad at Alan Rickman?
Doesn't he like cheat on somebody?
I'm not going to give away a spoiler.
I'm just telling her that's what it looks like. Does not want that vision of Alan Rickman in her head.
It's a fun... rom-com for the holidays, one of my favorite for the holidays, and it has the same kind of feel. The difficulty of taking these different stories and keeping you engaged with each of the characters, and the way that they blended them, the way that you'd see one moment that's just this passing moment where someone's having a conversation as the main people walk by, and then 15 minutes later you're in that conversation and they're the passing by
passerby thing. I thought it was brilliant, like which was a great opening, when Tripathi goes to kill the guy. Uh-huh. And I love that he had his gun right on his...
I did too, and he puts his leg up. And that shot with the green door falling in.
Oh, brilliant.
Brilliant shot.
Like this, you wouldn't think a film like this would have as beautiful of cinematography as it had. You'd think it was like...
It's easy to miss.
Yeah.
It's easy to miss.
But it was extremely beautiful.
This would be one of those films. If this had been released like in America, this would have been one of those films that right now I'd be screaming and saying, okay, Academy, don't miss the level of artistic brilliance in the cinematography, because this is such a quirky, funny movie.
Mm-hmm.
This movie deserves, and I'd be jumping up and down if it got a nod for cinematography, because he has some shots that are just straight up like throwaways.
Mm-hmm.
It's like you could be sitting there eating your popcorn, sitting in your underwear, and he just threw a diamond of cinematography in front of you and you just didn't even notice it.
Mm-hmm.
Ugh, it's just beautiful in so many ways.
I want to talk about the performances. Let's start off with Tripathi, because you know he's one of our absolute favorite. I think he's one of the best actors acting, period.
Yes.
Not no region attached to that.
Yeah.
He's legendary. He's one of the few, because it's difficult to be as good as he is in drama and also freaking hilarious. We've seen him in multiple things.
Yeah.
Him be just so funny.
Let's just look at the two things he has out right now. And how different those characters are. All of that gravitas in Mirzapur.
Mm-hmm.
He's playing a hitman, right? But he doesn't have any of that gravitas in the character. He's a funny character without being overplayed in a comical sense, like he did in Street, where that was a bit more over the top.
The thing that he's brilliant at in comedy is he doesn't play the shtick.
at all.
And that's why it's so funny. Because he's one of those guys that automatically has a weight just by looking at him.
Correct.
You're like, oh, he's intimidating.
Yeah.
But then he kind of just, he does his normal, like the fact that he was just, like he was so happy dancing to the song, and it was brilliant when they had their heads bobbing in the back.
I know, the guys in the back of the car.
Yeah, that's like, once again, the cinematography was just...
And great comedy moments like that throughout.
Yeah, so his whole character, and it was so different from his character that we saw on the street, and I know that we've only seen the tip of the iceberg, I guess, with Tripathy.
Yeah.
And we've seen a couple of his things, but like he's... It's extremely difficult to be as good as he is in drama.
Yes.
Few actors can do that.
Yes.
As much as I love Nawaz, I have not seen Nawaz do that.
It's really, really rare to have those kinds of roles happening simultaneously right now.
Mm-hmm.
Like Mirzapur is a hit show on right now, and this is a brand new film that's out right now, and they're completely different kinds of characters.
Yeah.
Completely different kinds of characters. Okay, I want to really sing the praises. We got what I was hoping we would get from Abhishek Bachchan.
Little B.
And I now want to watch more.
Yeah.
Because especially a couple of the more tender moments. Because I believe...
I loved the story with the little girl.
Wasn't it great?
Yeah.
That moment with the finger.
Mm-hmm.
And then later...
I was pissed off at the wife.
I know.
Like,
I know. There's very few instances. I was so mad at her.
Very few instances where I think that would ever be okay.
Yeah.
Like if you were a rape victim and you don't want to tell who the father. I get that. Whatever. That's one of the few extreme things. That
right.
If your husband goes to jail, that daughter still has the right to know who her father is.
Right. Not like, to be told another human being is their actual biological dad.
Maybe it's just because I'm a father now and it would just absolutely...
No, I'm with you. And I'm a dad too.
It pissed me off.
I'm with you. But I you know, that final scene where he's there and he's beautifully directed. When he just looks at her on this side and she goes to the other shoulder. And then he comes around over here and she goes to the other shoulder. His portrayal throughout, and this is the kind of performance I wanted to see,
mm-hmm.
where he wasn't doing much.
Yeah, yeah.
Where we just got to see him be on screen. And it made me really happy to see him do what I had expected we would see him do in trailers. And the fact that we've mentioned, when Big B is your dad, and you genuinely are wanting to be an actor yourself,
yeah.
it's inevitable. People are gonna be comparing you to a legend.
Oh, yeah. And the biggest legend.
Yeah. And so, it's like being Marlon Brando's kid.
Yeah.
So, hats off. He stood alone. He is him, you know, just in this one thing.
I thought that little girl who was always with him also did a phenomenal job.
That little girl was fantastic.
Yeah.
Great casting job in selecting that little girl.
The entire thing was well casted. And also, I loved when Tripathy made him speak like Amitabh Bachchan.
Yeah, I know him.
The other character.
The other guy's like, which one do you want? Do you want him from
Dwar?
Yes,
that was so hilarious. And the entire thing, it kept you on your feet this entire film.
Oh, yeah.
Like, there was a surprise every, 15 to 30 minutes.
Yeah, both in the plot twists mm-hmm. and also as to at what point are we going to see the characters...
intertwined.
Yeah, and you knew we're going to bring this to a head. You knew mm-hmm. this was going to have some kind of a climax. And I also love the narrators throughout the whole thing.
Yeah.
Those guys and the moral interplay of what's the moral to the story.
Yeah, that was so interesting. It was kind of similar to what they did in McBool.
Very.
Because what Nasiruddin Shah and Ompouri.
It's a very Shakespeare kind of thing to do.
Yeah. So I love that. And then obviously the graphics they did whenever he was hopping over a thing was great. Rajkumar Rao, man. He's one of the big... The India's best gems.
Yeah, he too can do anything.
That, because it's such a hilarious character. I loved every time he was sad, he had to dance. once again, the writing in this, because that.
You notice when he walked to the restaurant and he goes to the table, he throws the water bottle and it lands on the table behind him standing up.
The writing in this, obviously, I think is definitely the star of this film, because it's definitely an ensemble.
This whole thing really is Anurag Basu's, he's the star.
Oh, 100%. I'd love to see more from him in terms of, because I know we've only seen, this is now our second with him, but I would love to explore him more because he's such a unique director and he takes risks. Mm. And his writing is so brilliant in terms of one dialogue and all the twists and turns you get.
Okay. So how hard, not did you laugh, how hard did you laugh? Two moments. There were many. I had two moments that made me, three moments at the end. Mm-hmm. That made me just laugh out loud.
When he got hit with the car?
Yeah, the first one was tripping me, showing her the things and saying, this is what it will be for us. And he gets hit by the car the minute he steps out.
I love a good, I think, I forget who did it first. It might have been Mean Girls. Do you remember Mean Girls?
I didn't see Mean Girls. Yeah, I've never seen Mean Girls.
Hilarious.
I've heard.
It's not like a chick flick.
No, I've heard.
It's Tina Fey.
Yeah, I've heard.
It's freaking hilarious. But yeah. That's one moment I loved how they just ended. I was like, okay.
Well, I loved that. I loved how she takes him around to the trunk and Raj Kumar Rao lifts up the trunk. His look, and then how Raj Kumar Rao looks at him. And it's not the look of how are we going to get rid of the body. It's the look of, oh, he's really gone. I get her now. Oh, cool. We're free. And then in the credits, Trivathi's in a wheelchair. He didn't die. And he's just dancing with her in the wheelchair. So good. Laugh out loud funny.
Yeah, he just keeps living.
So good.
Maybe he doesn't die in Mizapur. He doesn't die.
No, he just doesn't die. And I genuinely feel like this is a literal cinematic blessing in the world right now. If there's something that people need who are stuck inside and it's now fall going into winter, to be able to have something like this to take your mind off of everything that's going on and have a lot of laughs, a lot of fun, appreciate great writing. This is really a gift.
And I want to praise the women in this as well. Say their names for me.
Oh, everybody in this was fantastic.
Pinky.
It reminded me a lot of Kubra Sate, didn't she a little bit?
Was she one of the girls in Dangal?
Was she? She was, wasn't she? I can tell just the minute you said that, I was like, that is one of the sisters.
Yeah, that's one of the sisters in Donda.
She
was also one of the...
Was both of them?
Oh, we're dumb.
No.
We're dumb.
The one with the curly hair.
Hold on. I'm going to go to it.
Was the other sister?
Yes.
They were. We're so stupid. Wow.
Wait, okay, so one was Babita.
Oh, I know exactly which one was which. Because the minute you said she was in it, I knew who she was. So she's the other one. Wow.
Yeah, we're dumb.
Well, they did a great job.
Oh, Angirak Baksu was in this?
Who?
What character did he play? The director.
He had a cameo? He did his... Wait a minute.
Who was he?
Was he the bald dude with the wig?
Let me see. He might have been.
The guy who worked at the hotel.
The guy who worked at the hotel.
Yeah, who goes to try to steal the thing and beats her up.
I wonder if he does, because a lot of directors do that. They like to have little cameos.
Yeah.
Quentin loves that.
Yeah.
But yeah, that might have been him. That's hilarious. But yeah, everybody in this did so, so well. And I want to, once again, the writing. Basu, in not being, because especially sometimes in Indian cinema, like the way I thought, like if they were, this girl was in a porn, the way I thought that would go in Indian, in India.
Right.
He took it a completely different direction.
Correct.
And so I like it when you surprise me with the writing.
Yes.
Not in terms of just like somebody get hit to the car, but in terms of not doing the normal thing I'm used to people doing.
Yeah.
With that kind of story.
Yeah.
But both of Raj Kumar Rao, the female in that one, and then the one with the sex tape.
Yeah.
Story was, I thought, really brilliant when they brought in the husband who you thought they were going to get all mad.
Right.
He was
a lot of surprises.
Yeah.
A lot of surprises that you didn't think were going to turn the way that they did.
Yeah. And yeah. I'm guessing him as a writer doesn't like those things as well. He's like, I don't want to be boring like that.
A good case in point, when he breaks the guy out of the hospital, I didn't see a crane coming. Did you? And I didn't see Trivathi jumping on.
No.
And joining him.
Oh, my God. Oh, so funny.
Yeah. Really fun.
Oh,
so much fun.
Lived up to the hype.
Yeah.
And I'm so glad. Definitely of the films that have come out this year, best film of the year.
100%.
And the Noir's
one. Favorite film of the year.
The Noir's one was up there as well, but this one I think is, I love this one way more.
Absolutely.
That one was just, that was a good film. This is, I think, a great film.
I agree.
And so I think, I'm hoping everybody saw
it. I agree. And this truly is, like, with the 10 picture category at the Oscars, this is the kind of film that would be a
contender.
It would be a Tika kind of a film where you'd be Jojo Rabbit.
Yeah.
Like a Jojo Rabbit, where you're thinking to yourself, they may not do it, but they should.
This will be a lot of people's favorite of the year.
Absolutely.
Like if, obviously, this won't this won't get to the Oscars. Sadly.
Right.
If it was an American film, it would.
It'd be talked about. It would be, it'd definitely be involved with Ensemble for SAG.
But like, if,
and
like
the Globes.
That's one of the things. It's frustrating with the Oscars is, if Jojo Rabbit was made in India, it wouldn't have made the Oscars.
Correct.
It's just
for a film that's why it was interesting to see Parasite get in there, because it had a level of quirkiness to it.
Yeah, it did.
Where ordinarily what the Academy has looked at, particularly, they've always done this with Best Picture, but particularly from any international film, is they want poignancy and they want power and they want something that's like exposing the raw underbelly.
So a Hell Row should have been.
Absolutely. Yeah. But a film like this would be appreciated and loved by audiences, but it could be really underrated for its artistic merits, which
Absolutely.
Are high
yeah,
level
artistry. Can't sing the praises of this one.
High level.
Want to see more from the director.
Yeah.
Everybody involved, Little B, Junior B. We call him Little B. I like that one better. But let us know what you thought about this film down below, and happy Diwali.
Happy Diwali.